Good morning. It's bright and early on a Saturday. We have to do the tasting so that Jackie and Lila can hit the road and go to Malibu.
It's a beautiful spring morning, and a quote-unquote young man's fancy turns to pink wines. A lot of folks in the United States think of pink wines as somewhat sweet white Zinfandel, which can be fairly good. Pink wines generally tend to be very good food wines, and Bernadette and I went shopping. This is part of our Costco adventure, and picked out 4 pink wines.
I think they only had 5, and we bought 4 of the 5.
80%. We have 2 pink bubblies. I know what the wines are. I don't know which order they're in. One is a French non-vintage rosé champagne. The other is a California sparkling wine made like champagne. And then we have 2 rosés from Provence. One rosé that is unoaked. Classically, Provençal wines are unoaked. One that is oaked, that I hate, but we'll see. Give it another chance. In making pink wines, you're making them from red grapes, and the color from the grapes is in the skin. So you have some skin contact to give you the red color, and then you're pressing it fairly quickly so you don't get too much tannin in the wine. There are other ways of making rosés, but we'll do that at another time. These were all made with some skin contact. So the first wine, this deep pink, but it's pink with a hint of yellow or orange, we call partridge eye color. I know most of you haven't been gazing longingly into the eyes of your local partridge, but partridges have eye color similar to this. This one is a bit darker.
Yeah, even at 8 o'clock in the morning, this is pretty good.
It's pretty good. Lots of strawberry, raspberry fruit, but there's toasty notes from a good amount of time spent on the yeast cells, the lees. In making champagne or sparkling wine, you make a base wine, and then you add that base wine with some sugar and yeast, and a second fermentation occurs in the bottle, and that causes a yeast sediment. And the longer that wine sits on the yeast sediment, the toastier, creamier it gets, but the more expensive it is because it takes years for that to happen. So this is really toasty, creamy, long, nice acidity. You like it?
Love it.
You love it.
Great wine for the hot tub as well. Or any summer party, happy hour. It's very versatile, isn't it?
It is. Bernadette loves to have bubbly in the hot tub. Isn't that true, baby?
It's true.
Okay, and then we're going to contrast it. A good way of learning about wine is to compare one with the other. And the second wine, it's got really nice crushed strawberry fruit. It's fresh, but it isn't as rich or as long as the first one. Pleasant.
I agree. I like it, but I guess depends on the cost, too.
It depends upon the cost. So the first wine, I think, is the Veuve Clicquot non-vintage rosé champagne. And the second wine is our pleasant but much less expensive California sparkling wine.
And you are right.
Okay, so we have Veuve Clicquot, meaning the Widow Clicquot, very nice, bought, I think it was $50-some-odd. And then we have California, made by Moët Chandon, and which is about $16. For $16, very good buy. Mm-hmm. Though if you want to have something really spectacular,
special.
Have something special, the Veuve Clicquot.
Okay, let's go on to the next two.
So the next two wines, in comparison, don't look nearly as pink, right? They look off.
Almost,
slightly pink.
Yeah, almost a peachy color.
But this can be often the color of Provençal wines. They're usually based on Grenache, can have other varieties as well, Sanso and Syrah, Mourvèdre. So when you smell the first wine, let's just smell compare.
It's good.
It smells good, but it has oak, or as the French would say, hoc, on the wine.
Hoc?
Hoc.
Hoc.
Hoc. And there is no hoc on the second one, right?
The second one smells better.
So let's taste the second one first.
Good, but not the best rosé I've ever had.
First off, it's very difficult to go from champagne or sparkling wine to rosé. Since the acid's so high in the sparkling wine, these wines, which have good enough acid,
taste a little flat.
Okay, take that into consideration. It's got nice fruit. It's rich on the mid palate. It's got a nice creamy finish. So one of the reasons why the wine isn't as pink is that it is set on yeast cells in the tank or large, very large barrels for some period of time, and that tends to absorb some of the color. Nice classic Provençal rosé. They used to go for $10-$12 a bottle. They've become more popular. This one's $20-some-odd a bottle. And This wine is an interesting wine in that it's an oaked rosé. Most rosés are not oak. And the reason being is that the oak detracts from the delicacy of the wine and gives you these nasty, bitter tannins. A few years ago, I was at a rosé tasting in New York with our friend Robin Kelly O'Connor, and we went around and tasted over 100 rosés. And the table that had the biggest crowd was this table, Whispering Angel, which has interesting packaging. And people were lined up to taste Whispering Angel, and so I tasted it, and I thought, oh my God, this is vile. I can't drink it. God bless people who buy it. They apparently buy it in droves. Some of them, I think, when they can't get it, or they can be found with a bottle of vanilla extract laying next to them, half open, as they guzzle the vanilla extract in lieu of their Whispering Angel. Now, you can turn any good wine into a crappy wine by pouring some vanilla extract in it.
And you want to pour a little in my good rosé?
Sure, we will make it so that the Hoke lovers would... This is only giving the vanilla flavor, it's not giving the bitter tannins. We don't quite have an answer for that one yet.
Not as vile as I was expecting. Now it tastes more like the Whispering Angel, but... You destroyed my wine.
I destroyed... I guess
if I were really, really thirsty, I might be able to drink some of it.
Call me a bâtard. Would you get the wines, Bernadette?
Of course.
So, rosés, great food wines. And one of the reasons is that they're unoaked, except for this one. Rosé bubbly, very versatile food wine. You could have almost with anything, believe it or not. If I was going to select out food, this last wine with almost any food.
I could suggest next time we buy some of the rosés that we really love. I think we've found a few of them at Trader Joe's.
And other places as well.
Before the summer, because they are great summer wines. It's hot outside and you don't feel like drinking a red wine.
Yeah. Now, if you have a wine that is over-oaked and you're trying to salvage it, having it with food cooked over oak is a way of doing it. It was a restaurant in Seal Beach called Walt's Wharf, one of my favorite restaurants around, that cooks wonderful fish on oak grills, and is one of the rare times that oak Chardonnay is a good pairing and a good food one. That's our little introduction to rosé.
And if you've liked our channel, please subscribe, give a like.
What? Like, comment, and subscribe.
Okay. Why don't you say it?
Like, comment, and subscribe, per favore.
And we'll give more wine lessons.
Till next time. Oh, I'm going to cheers with the
best one.
The best one, of course. Cheers.
Cheers. Let's take a hot tub.